Where'd you get that brooch?
You gave it to me, Bessie.
Jane! Jane Eyre! A grown young lady, and you were such a tiny thing, no higher than a broomstick. Oh, Miss Jane. That's your poor aunt.
Oh, don't tell Aunt Reed I'm here, or Cousin John, or anyone.
Master John isn't here anymore. As soon as he was of age, he was off to London. Gambling, that's what it was. Thousands and thousands of pounds the missus paid for him. She had to shut up most of the house and turn off the other servants. But still he kept plaguing her for money. Then, last summer, he killed himself, Miss Jane. They found him hanging in his room and the cards still on the table where they'd played the night before. And they told the missus she had a kind of stroke, wandering like in her mind.
Is that you, Bessie?
Yes, ma'am.
Who are you? Go away.
I'm Jane, Aunt Reed. Jane Eyre.
Jane Eyre. Nobody could know the trouble I've had with that child. Little pauper, Brett. Should have been in the workhouse. Jane Eyre. Oh, don't leave me, Jane. Please don't leave me.
I won't leave you.
Oh, no, sir. Mrs. can't see nobody. She's been ill for months.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wanted to make some inquiries about a niece of hers, Miss Eyre.
Oh, would you wait inside a moment, sir?
Thank you. Thank you.
Gentlemen, to see you, Miss Jane.
Oh, I don't want to see him. I don't want to see anyone.
No, don't be foolish. You can't live all alone like the man on the moon. I'll sit with the missus. Run along now. He's waiting.
Jane!
How did you know I was here?
I didn't. I was trying to find you. I received an inquiry about you the other day. Didn't stay in that place you went to very long, did you? Didn't you like it? What happened?
I had to leave.
Forgive me, it's no business of mine. All the same, I do feel obliged to ask you about this letter. It comes from a lawyer in Milcote. He writes to me as the person whose name you gave as reference when you went to Thornfield. That's near Milcote, isn't it? A client of his wants to know your whereabouts. You know who's inquiring for you? Jane, if you don't want me to talk about this anymore, I won't.
Thank you, Dr. Rivers.
It's for you to say. Or would you rather I didn't answer it at all?
Shillings, that's much better, thank you very much, sir. 27 and 6, 30 shillings, 35, Bob. Any advance of 35, £2 is bid. Go in at £2. Go in. Take it away, Bill.
Thank you. seemed the cry of a soul in pain, an appeal so wild and urgent that I knew I must go, and go quickly. Only when I knew what had happened to him, only when I'd looked once more upon that tortured face, could I make my decision.
It was she who did it, Miss Eyre. She struck down Grace Poole as she slept, and then she set fire to Thornfield. It was her laugh in the gallery that woke me. I ran into the nursery and wrapped Adele in a shawl and carried her down. And as we came out into the courtyard, I heard her laugh again. I looked up, and there she was on the roof, laughing and waving her arms above the battlements. Mr. Edwards saw her as he came out. He did not say anything, but went straight back into the house to try to save her. All this side of the house was blazing. There was smoke everywhere. Then it cleared. And suddenly we saw Mr. Edward behind her on the battlements. She saw him too. He came towards her to help her down. She stood very still for a moment. And just as he seemed to reach her, he gave a dreadful scream and ran from him to the edge. The next moment, she lay smashed on the pavement before us. She was dead, Miss Eyre.
Mr. Edward.
The great staircase fell in as he was coming down.
Supper.
Yes.
Here, pilot. Clear. Who are you?
I've come back, sir. Edward.
Very fingers. Small, soft fingers. Here. A little flower soft face.
And a heart too, Edward.
Jane. All you can feel now is mere pity. Such a pity.
Edward.
Can't spend your life on the mere wreckage of a man. You're young and fresh. You want to get married.
Don't send me away. Please don't send me away.
You think I want to let you go?
The months went past. He came to see the light once more, as well as to feel its warmth. To see first the glory of the sun, and then the mild splendor of the moon, and at last the evening star. And then one day, when our firstborn was put into his arms, he could see that the boy had inherited his own eyes as they once were, large, brilliant, and black.